What's up, everyone? It's Saturday, July 31st, 2021, and it's 68 Fahrenheit, 20 degrees Celsius. It's 2:20 in the afternoon, and we are driving to Palos Los Verdes right now. It is a peninsula at the southwest corner of Los Angeles. Currently, we're in San Pedro, which is a neighboring community, a seaside community. But yeah, let's check out Palos Verdes Peninsula. I've heard that there's really great views there and lots of beautiful homes. I'm also joined in the car with Tracy and John.
Hello.
They'll be assisting me through this drive and letting me know what's around. They've been in LA a lot longer than I have. But originally, the Palos Verdes Peninsula was home to the Tongva Native Americans people for thousands of years.
So I'm originally from Brooklyn, New York, but I've been out here 30 years, and I met my husband, John, 30 years ago, and he's Tongva Gabrielino Native American Indian. So, this is his area, but we live in Orange County right now, but we're excited to show Kenneth around the beautiful coastal cliffs and hills of this area.
There's a lot of hills around here. I guess this is in a way taking John back to his ancestral homelands, right? On the peninsula?
Yeah, we think that, it's probably our ancestors were on Catalina Island. They call it Pima. And they traveled, they made boats, they traveled back and forth onto the mainland. Some people, they stay, went back and forth. Villages. I think it was just pretty common. A lot of them travel to other places too. Further away and whatnot.
Set up the missions up in San Gabriel.
Yeah, that was later on during the Spanish settlements. There's a lot of archaeological information online. It's fairly detailed about this.
So, John, tell them about you and your family protecting the sites now that they're developing to protect the bones of your ancestors and reinter them.
Yeah, that's my uncle is in development and monitors the sites, and there was a lot of money. Probably LA's biggest development, real estate development, Playa Vista. He recently placed a monument there and reinterred it and figured out burials. That was starting about maybe 23 years ago. Pretty much all settled now.
And John and his family. Oh, I hope nothing big is burning down.
Well, it's the fire department, it's not an ambulance.
John and his family perform annually at the Long Beach Aquarium. They have an annual Bonita Festival in which local Native American tribes perform and have exhibits.
Yeah, I think it was canceled because of the pandemic, and then they kind of scale it down a little bit, but hopefully we perform again.
So I guess this road goes straight into Palos Verdes?
Correct, right.
Okay. Yeah, there's multiple routes within Palos Verdes itself. It's not just like one road. It's a whole community, a network of like different properties within those hills there.
Right, there's like rolling estates. There's different sections of the area. Right now, this is 25th Street. Residential, but as you can see, really well maintained.
And extremely steep too.
The sea air smells so good too.
Yeah, we're going uphill, but facing the other way, there's great views of the harbor.
Uh-huh. See all of it, the coastline and all the nice homes pretty shortly. San Pedro is nice too.
So San Pedro is famous for their fish market and Ports of Call Village, but they're renovating it, working on it right now. There's still some great places to go to on the coast of San Pedro, but it gets pretty busy.
All that in front of us.
A few little shops and stuff. But it's known for outdoor seafood, huge platters of shrimp and lobster and lots of fish. Delish, delish.
I guess so. It's known for the seafood being right on the coastline. Yeah, right in front of us is all Palos Verdes. All up those hills.
So Palos Verdes means Ranch of the Green Sticks.
Oh, that makes sense. Verdes. Spanish. Green Sticks, huh? Why it was named after that. Were there a lot of green sticks there?
Must be the trees.
Hmm.
Because there is a botanical garden up here and different parks up on viewing points, lagoons that whales are migrating through. Some hiking, horseback riding, surfers, drivers, bicyclists.
Palos Verdes, there's the border. I'm gonna see some epic views now.
Right.
Okay.
So,
imagine what some of these homes must cost. At least $3 million, I think.
Yes, definitely. At least. You know, $1 million is cheap here in Southern California for a lot of people. You know, $1 million homes are all over the place. But yeah, these are only $3 seats.
Wow, look at this view. It's something else. There's also a golf course on the left. Way different than any of the other beach cities, even though this one's on the coast. It's not really a beach city, it's like a lot of just nice homes here and good views. There's like a hotel here where you can walk around the perimeter. It's really nice. I was also going to say it kind of looks like Malibu a little bit.
Yes. Malibu, even Ventura, Santa Barbara, all the way up to San Francisco along the water. It's pretty endless. Thank you.
Yeah, it is Terranea. No, we can do it on the way back.
Obviously, most
This is a cool little space in the right
corner. The bay, yeah. This over here. Yeah. This is actually like all Palos Verdes estates. Yeah, it is. Oh, it says to the right, actually. Mm-hmm. Yeah, going to is redundant.
And then back down to Long Beach?
You can go from Redondo to the freeway and then Long Beach. Be better. Yeah. Because now this is exiting Palos Verdes.
Is that the road kind of went from the intersection?
Yeah. Yeah, folks, that was Palos Verdes. How about those views and the,
Where's Torrance?
Where's Torrance now? I didn't know Palos Verdes bordered Torrance. I guess we'll be ending the video here. If you enjoyed it, then smash the like button for me. Subscribe for some more videos like these. And I'll see you next time. Take care, everyone.
Bye.
Bye.